I'm really nervous today. I've been like writing lyrics down solidly now for a couple of weeks, every day. And I've never done that before at the start of any project. And I just want a load of artillery so I've got me when I go in. So this is what I've got. I've got this. There you go.
Take that or to lose Robbie Williams just weeks before the
Oh, what a beast! Oh, what a man!
Take that, confirm that they are splitting up.
And from today, there's no more.
Take that as being...
I'm rich beyond my wildest dreams!
I was always the talented member of the band.
Robbie Williams is facing up to his demons, enrolling himself at a rehab clinic in a moment.
Take that, the boy band of the 90s are reforming for a UK tour.
This is the perfect time and the perfect moment for that something other than being Robbie Williams to happen. And it just so happens that they're massive. And that's the way it's worked out.
Right, let's go into that second verse. Do you want to go back to the top and go same again?
We drop the second, put the money back, and we erased each line of laughter track, and I could be home if I could be gone in anything. Should I come in for a bit then? Yeah? How was that?
Good.
It's a bit scary putting words to the epic ones. They've got to be epic themselves.
The decision is really where do we want the song to go?
We should link our chorus with what Rob's done.
With the verse,
yeah.
So it's about.
There's a lot of years gone between us guys. A lot of missing years, and I can't imagine when. We're going to make an album over the next 8-12 months and not address some of those issues and repave some of those paths.
Those people obscure the view.
So, guys,
yeah.
It's don't stay where you're not loved.
Got it.
It's always been my hope that we'd do something. I always had this vision in my head that when we're about 65 years old, we'd all get round a piano and play some songs and do a little bit of stuff together, but thankfully it's come 25 years earlier than I thought it would.
Yeah. Standing on the edge of forever, at the start of whatever, shouting love at the world instead of shouting love at the heart of the world.
We've all been on a hell of a journey and we're all arriving back to where we started, and we're going to create something as really five different people than when we started. But there's always going to be an issue me working with Rob.
2 bars in, Mark. So, just give you a bit more of an Apache. Here we go.
Too many strings, isn't it?
Like a bullet in my head.
Too soft?
Beauty, beauty. Love it.
Done.
I've been sceptical about him coming back in the band. I'd like to think it would be cool and everything would be fine and it would be tight-knit, but from what I've experienced, Robbie's got a very changeable mind.
In order of priority, of mattering most, things that matter the most, it's us being together, being okay with each other, getting on and, you know, repairing old wounds, if they are repairable.
What a vibe, just walking from the hotel here.
Yeah,
New York. It's a good place to be in.
Do you want to eat some stuff?
I just want to fucking have a little catch up with the boys first, though, for a few minutes. I want to feel really relaxed when I listen. It's all right, Rob.
Yeah, I do.
I was going to say, I was going to have like a mini band meeting. It's like, I'm just a bit nervous and a bit scared, and I have been for a few days, you know. And I want to...
It's going to take a while, though, mate. It took us 4 years. Should have seen us, like, when we got back together after that time. It took us a long time to get to know each other again, didn't it?
Yeah.
You know, I want you to know that I probably will be a bit quiet. You know, I've been in the house for 3 years and I haven't gone out at all.
Everybody's got to find their space. I think that's the thing, isn't it? You've got to find your own space within it all.
Yeah.
That's quite...
Are you nervous, Ab?
Yeah, I suppose I am, yeah.
What about?
About feeling part of it, really, I suppose. You know what I mean? You've got three great writers and it's like...
Howard said when we got off the plane, he said, should we make up a dance routine so we can show him something when we turn up? Me and Howard come in like that. We've got some of the lads. We're contributing. Two Muppets at the back. It's brilliant. Should we call it off?
Knock it on the head.
Knock it on the head. Bad idea.
No, this is...
Bobbin's idea.
This is going to be a bit really, really good.
Good, yeah. Let's get the songs.
Cool, let's play a couple of things because I want to get back to the hotel and have a thinking about with lyrics.
Yeah. On those ones we've done today?
Yeah.
You have to sing, Rob.
Is there?
Computer.
Standing. We both want each other. I don't need to come in and stamp my authority on anything. I'm looking forward to there being a process in the middle of us, because that'll be the best way for me to get to know everybody. My hope is that that friendship will regenerate itself somehow. I want to play a game while we get to know each other, and the playing of the game is writing the tunes. But I am kind of sweaty and shaky. You know, it's that jumping out of a plane thing. And I've packed my own parachute, and that's really worrying.
Under
Thanks, innit?
Yeah. Whatever happened, by hook or by crook, I said it before and I'll say it again. We've got to do it. Just got to do it, whatever it takes.
Oh, it's got to be
fallout,
done.
Fallout, arguments, tears, whatever.
You yeah. never can do a press conference. As from today, no more.
No more.
You see these two fighting again with the stalkers.
With lightsabers.
History repeating itself.
Yeah. I won't be there. are we putting up SOS?
SOS.
Right?
Yeah. SOS?
Yes, please, mate.
Yeah.
As we were when the band got back together after 10 years.
The will he or won't he debate has raged ever since Take That got back together without their fifth member, Robbie Williams. Now they've given their strongest hint yet they could be heading for an original lineup reunion by hooking up together at a New York recording studio.
Down to me, Gasano. It's down to me to come up with ideas, because if I don't come up with ideas,
yeah.
I feel like I can't compete. If nothing's right, then I've tried. And
yeah.
I've tried and I've tried putting the input into the album, and that's what matters.
We'll make sure it's right.
Okay, here we go. One, two.
Now, Robbie Williams, is he really holed up with the Take That boys in New York working on new material?
I'll tell you exactly what we're doing here. The Winter Olympics are coming up, and we think of entering the first five-man bobsleigh team to the UK.
For Robbie Williams back in the studio with the rest of the boys.
Hey.
That's all
hey. I like the bit in between.
Yeah.
What up?
Quite like that.
Word.
Is this a sample you brought in, Al?
That's lovely. That's quite simple. Like cool. Dark as well. Got that.
How about that? Play again.
To be honest, Rob, I prefer it anyway. If we all. You didn't have the pressure of thinking you've got to do all these great lyrics. We all should feel the same. You shouldn't feel any more or less pressure to get lyrics out.
Yeah. Wait, there's something that I want to say. Something that be hid away. Something that I'd like to change.
Don't know what I feel, then it stopped.
It's great, that, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We didn't have that this morning.
It's funny how we're all casually sat here.
Five of us.
Sat here, but you know, it's only us sat in it.
When you walked in today, it just felt,
you know, maybe I'm saying it a bit prematurely, but it felt whole again. already, day two. Felt like, all right, we're all here now.
This is good today, because this is our first real five of us in a room, this.
It was horrible when it first came here, wasn't it?
Came where?
Came here, New York. It was horrible.
Aside from the laughs that we shared, we had, us lads, it was all shit, one of those years. Just shit.
Yeah. Unnecessary, most of it.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Where the bloody donkey's doing it, though.
Hey.
Hey,
you guys gonna be touring in the US?
Hey, having a lovely time, thank you.
Are you gonna be teaming up with Robbie again?
Oh, I don't know.
The rumours have been circulating for months that one of the most successful boy bands ever could be working together.
Today, Robbie Williams confirmed he has been recording.
The band might reunite for a special Children in Need event held at the Royal Albert.
With us, and he must be sick to the back teeth of everyone asking you about when he's coming back or if he's coming back.
Really what we want is to see them all back on stage and the lads reunited. We know they've started to do some music together. We just need that final step now and that final push.
What are we going to do tonight? Jay reckons we shouldn't, because we shouldn't blow the opportunity.
You shouldn't do what?
Have the picture together.
I was saying, it seems a shame if we're going to blow that shot. The five of us haven't been seen together before for 15 years, and let's save it.
Let's just see what happens naturally. I don't think we have to.
Giving us all. Give us all.
Yeah, but I will do. Though, will not.
But that's okay, because that's an introduction and a really natural one.
Yeah. Well, it's fine to say that here. Let's just be natural in this dressing room. But we're all going to be so far away from feeling natural out there.
I don't think what we do want is that 5 minutes of silence. Of we're all hugging each other. I think it's almost come on the stage, strike the band straight away.
No, it's a reunion.
Just like, cheers, lads.
It's not a reunion, is it?
No, it's not.
Come on, Beth.
Yeah. See now,
get off my stage.
It's a big moment, a lot of people said, seeing the band reunited.
To me, it seems like just a beautiful moment for us to be introing you, saying hi to you. Here's our friend Robbie. Off you go.
Yeah.
And we don't. I know what you're saying. We don't need to think too much. But it's that simple. Mm. People love it. We're not singing together tonight. So let's at least give them us saying hello to you.
Also, if you come on one way and the boys go off the other side, it's literally a handover of the stage.
Yeah. I've been talked around. Let's put it that way. Succumbed again, as per usual.
No, but
otherwise, he's going to come on.
Yeah, come on.
And then you go to you, and then there's that 5 minutes. Yeah. Gap, you're talking about while they're waiting for us to have a little lovey dovey group therapy hug, which is going to look shite.
Yeah, that's
why don't we just why don't we just clap them?
Yeah.
Why don't we clap them?
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah.
Look at the four of us, me, Jason, Gary and Mark. I think we are really bonded, more so than ever. And now Rob's come in for this album. I think it must be hard for him because Robbie is not the most confident of people.
I don't want Rob to disappear. I'm just, it's the worst possible thing. And I think Rob is fragile, I really do.
He does have low confidence at times, like everybody else. He's a normal person. He's never been great at touring. He's always had stage fright. People just get the idea that he walks around with an ego all the time, but he doesn't.
Okay, see you out there. So, Jay, what did you say earlier? What should we say?
Hello there.
It was kind of scary leaving New York, because I felt safe with all the lads. And then I'd got to go off and be a solo artist again and, I'd stand in front of the camera and I wouldn't be in charge of my hands. This really weird feeling of something that used to come so natural was now not there. So please dig deep into your pockets and thank you very, very much for making it. And I was scared of the machine and what it means to be out there.
Remember to drop our mic stand straight back as soon as we finish.
OK, we're ready to go, gentlemen.
If we hadn't have come back as a band, we wouldn't have seen Rob again.
We needed to meet again as equals, with equal success, back in a great place, and we're equals at the moment. To have a real ball with us. I want to see him alive on stage. So I've not seen it for years. And if it helps him find Robbie again, then that's going to be great.
It's a great occasion for us all to be on this stage. And what a perfect time for us to introduce an old friend to you right now. Please welcome on stage Robbie Williams.
Going to me, were we? I was ready for Never Forget Me.
Back in my ass.
That was nice. Really nice being up there with him, though, eh? Wasn't it?
It was brilliant. A little tease of that for us.
Don't cock up the whole thing, if you ask me.
Did he say don't cock up?
So Robbie Williams and Take That have been reunited on stage for the first time.
Take That and Robbie will always get until the deed is formally done. When will the band be back for good?
We need to get the balance right of what it is and where it is and how it is. But it's shaping up to be very, very exciting.
We want it to be a one-off night when we stand and do a song. We want to do something a bit more substantial, so that will come.
And talks are ongoing.
All the time.
When Robbie was on board with us, it reinvigorated my excitement, reignited my excitement. So then when he pulled out again, it was like the rug from under your feet. I was gutted.
Yeah, you feel a bit of a fool, because you started to believe. I suppose that was more of it. Oh, we just started to believe. And then, yeah, that's the fragility of everything, isn't it?
When I heard just before I went on holiday, oh, Rob doesn't want to do it now, I thought, what the fuck's this? What are we going to do? You know, we had hits, that was my problem. We had big songs already written, and it was like, what a waste.
I remember sending Robbie an email saying, this is about life.
this is. This is about the five of us. You know, let's enjoy it.
I wasn't very well, you know, physically. I just didn't feel as though I had the energy to do it. You know, it was a scary prospect. To be out there amongst something that would be so huge when you're feeling depleted of life force.
The unfortunate thing is, when you're part of a group and you've got that kind of changeable mind, we're all gonna suffer the consequences, you know, we're gonna feel it as well. I actually said to Rob, you know, your whims have a direct effect on us. But equally, none of us were gonna say to Rob, no. We were gonna try and strongly encourage him, but none of us were gonna say, no, you must do this, because we tried to manipulate him and each other back in the day, and we didn't want manipulation to be a part of it. It was his choice.
I went round to Rob's and went round a couple of times, because it's just better if you can speak to each other, isn't it, I think? And we worked out that day. We said, forget about promotion, forget about touring, because that's a big thing. It's always daunting, that, because you know it's a year. But let's just say we just make this record. Let's look at how many days it's going to take us, max. And we're kind of working out, and we said it's going to take about 30 days of you actually being in a studio over this next year. Do you want to do it? Yeah, I want to do it. Well, have you got 30 days spare? Yeah, I've got 30 days spare. All right, let's do it.
How are you doing?
Oh, right. What happened?
To me, I don't know. I haven't had a look at it. Cheers, man.
So I'm not in trouble.
Everybody's been really good.
You're in trouble.
Except for one of us.
Yeah, everyone's been really good.
Well, listen, my priority is you.
These are key days.
Yeah, I mean, it's a thing that it's going to be...
This is the best bit.
Mm. Yeah. But it's a process, yeah. It's something that we have to work out whilst we're in here. It's something we wanted to talk about. You know, how we're going to find... We have to find a way to agree with something. And I don't know how we're, you know, whether we're always going to do that or how we're going to do it or what's the process there.
Well,
we're going to keep hitting walls.
Actually, me personally, I'm not afraid of hitting some walls. That's, for me, this process is as much about was getting beyond the walls we hit,
yeah,
than it is producing some great lyric or a great melody or whatever. It's about us communicating properly. Because,
yeah.
Rob, I used to think when people would say...
Don't say a bad thing. Go on.
Rob's ego. The ego has landed and missed. I always thought that you were playing on that. I always thought that was an image that you were putting out there because it was appealing at that time. But then a few times that I met you over the years, I walked away and I thought, oh, right, he's living it. He really has got a big ego and he's admitting it and living it. And you do get depressed if your albums don't go up to number one and you're not the king of pop. But I thought that. I always thought that you could have taken or leaving it. I always thought you didn't give a shit, really. You were just getting away with it.
Well, I will say the only time I bumped into you was when you said they're calling you the king of pop.
A couple of times we bumped into each other. That was one of them. Yeah.
But, you know, I have to say that I thought your ego was... You've got an ego.
I know, you're probably right.
There was two.
I didn't see mine.
Well, there was two people, you know, there was...
Rubbing.
Hitting each other the wrong way.
It's funny, because yesterday I had a moment like that, and it hit me, and I wanted to bring it up at some point about what time when to discuss it, really, because when you said to me, I don't think you'll ever be happy with anything unless you've done it, you said to me, which I just went, oof. But it's something that I have to deal with.
I don't know what you mean.
Well, sometimes Mark comes in with a fucking absolute hit melody, and you do have days, you do, where you come in, and it doesn't matter what you put on that table, you won't have it unless you've come up with it.
But that's why we're all here, is to deal with this shit. But it could be great if we get tried.
To do and what records we want to do, what music we want to do, what tour we want to do. Whereas back then, our lives were completely taken over by Take That, and it was too much, really. I didn't like it.
It's Take That!
We got programmed. Always stood together, you had our certain positions, you know. It was like we were all reading this manual of how to be a pop star, how to do this, and we were all reading the book and seeing certain bits that we liked. And initially, it was a bit awkward, but all of a sudden, it gelled, it came together, and we created this thing that was Take That. When you're within the band, you don't really realise how big you are. There's a lot of chaos where you go and stuff, but I suppose when I was growing up during that time, or trying to. The difficult thing was is that we didn't really know our own identities. We knew how to be pop stars before we knew how to be men. I wasn't really contributing in the writing, I wasn't really a great dancer, I wasn't really a great singer, so then what am I here for? Could have been anybody. Could have been anybody. I just probably smiled the right way, or
You know, I won a smiling competition back in Oldham when I was 5 or 6, and I realised that that's where my training came from.
I think it cuts deep with the other four, rather than me. We were just en route, I felt. I felt like I was just constantly en route to somewhere else. This wasn't it. I'm about to leave all this.
We were picked. And we were a product. And it was really successful product. But you don't realise how much you're giving away as you're gaining your popularity and as you're gaining your success. You're losing a lot, really. Some small part of you is saying to you, you're selling out on stuff here, you know, you're losing bits of you. There was a big payoff for us, because, you know, you get paid more being a pop star than you do most jobs, or a lot of jobs. But there was a big cost, and it does affect you.
Big formative years, 16, 17, 18, 19. Go out and find a job and be in the real world. And, you know, get to find out how much milk costs. No, I didn't do that. You know, I got a different kind of education, which is 100 girls outside your mum's house and your mum having to draw the curtains and not opening the curtains for 3 years. Because people just come up the drive and take grass and a coachload of German people arrive on Thursdays, and then the police have to cordon off the road because there's too many people, and you're like embarrassed, you know, and kind of, you know, you go from 0 to 1,000 and you don't realise where you're going, but you only know that you've got there once you turned around and go, fuck, how'd you deal with this?
Did people say, did it make you happy? Did it make you happy, though, Jay? First time round?
Well, you know as well as I know. Part of it did, part of it does, part of it don't.
You know, it's like, yeah, I understand the amazing position that we're in, and we are fucking beyond fortunate, and what I've managed...
Et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
Well, what I've managed to do is stretch an elastic band to the moon with what I've got, you know, and it is amazing, but, you know, doesn't stop situations from making you feel uncomfortable and having anxiety, you know, and yeah, I think a lot of my moaning is the fact that, you know, I'm a depressed person, you know, with or without this. I would have been a depressed person because, you know, it's evident that half of my family are depressed people that struggle, whether they've had, you know, whether they've sold 50 million albums or not. Mm. I think I'd be lying if I just went, yeah, everything's really cool. I'm a bit like you, but I think people really want to know.
Yeah.
I think people really want to know what it's like or about.
Yeah.
Everything Changes, the hit song by Take That, proved to be true to life after their singer Robbie Williams' decision to go it alone. Watch me come
Nobody's got the emotional tools to deal with millions of people looking at you. Nobody has. Every gesture that you do or every eye thing that you make, you know, you make yourself 200, 300, 1,000 times bigger than the person you are. I think they'd be really bored if they got me. I put an album out every fucking year as well. It was like 7 years where I put one out every year, sometimes two.
Live the dream.
Live the nightmare.
Once you're on that treadmill of promotion, tour and, you know, all of the above, there is no what does it feel like. Feels like France. Feels like this dressing room. Feels like that interview I've just given where I've just said something dodgy.
Here with Robbie Williams. Tell us about Don't Tell My Booker. What is tonight about?
I haven't got a clue. I'm just out to find a wife.
the boom of the internet and the boom of tabloids going from page seven to the whole of the newspaper being about celebrity gossip, you know, you are kind of hunted. After a while, that weighs down on you. It weighs down on anybody.
Robbie Williams is facing up to his demons this lunchtime, enrolling himself at a rehab clinic in America.
The pop star's admitted trying pretty well every kind of illegal substance in his colourful career, but he says what's got hold of him now is a serious addiction to prescription drugs.
If I hadn't gone to rehab, I'd be dead. As dramatic as that sounds, and drama queeny, you know, stuff was starting to pack up. Left arm was going numb, and, you know, I was doing things to myself that other people have died from in the last 12 months, you know.
Hey, Rob, how you doing, bud?
I'm doing very good, thank you.
Very good. How was rehab, man?
Very good. Excellent. Excellent. I'm almost off everything.
Good, good.
As you get bigger, you will get smaller and smaller and smaller until it comes down to this bedroom. And that's what my world is this bedroom, my missus and the dogs. And I'm really happy with that. You know, it's a place of peace, and this is the compound that I don't leave, and I don't leave out of choice.
Hey, Gaz,
Alton's discography, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, he had two albums out, 74, 75, he had two albums out. 76.
Hello,
he's
sir.
Here. We're looking at your
diagram. You're in the prone position.
We're reading your discography. Here, check this out. Okay, check this out. You're a lazy bastard.
Right. 80,
81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 88. You let the slide down there.
Yeah.
89, 1992, 93, 95, 97, 2001, 2004, 2006.
I'm so happy to be here. Except there's a war. This cold cup of sick.
If we were playing top trumps, you've just won.
Yeah.
Oh.
Should we play out on something?
Go on. One more.
Have you got time?
Of course.
You know how big this is going to be? If you have any idea the joy when this comes out for people, it's going to be... You've never sounded better.
Thank you.
That's just a demo, isn't it?
Is it just a demo?
Yeah.
For Stuart, right?
Yeah.
Just whip it up in 10 minutes. Good luck. Yeah. Better than that, it's fucking brilliant. Seriously, you've never sounded better.
Thank you.
Pour underground machine.
And it's so exciting.
Just play it just a little bit of this one.
Come on,
because this is going to be...
A vocal.
Yeah, there is.
That's a number one single, that is.
It's good, isn't it?
But they're all fucking brilliant. Almighty.
I know.
The world's gonna go mad in England.
You've got the moves for that one, everything. You've got the moves for it.
I know. It's fantastic. How does it feel for you to be back in... I mean, you're the happiest you've been for years.
Yep.
Thank God.
Yeah, I was in before everybody today waiting.
Really?
Was it?
That's so great for you.
Just feels right.
Just feels right, doesn't it? It does feel right.
Yeah. You all deserve the happiness. You deserve it. They've already refound their happiness, and you deserve all the happiness coming to you.
Thank you.
You do, and maybe this time you'll believe it.
Yeah, I think this will mean more than anything.
I know, of course.
Than
it will.
Any of it.
Yeah, of course it will. Tears of mine to see all you guys together again.
That's good, isn't it?
Yeah, it's wonderful.
Come on, let's get on with this.
Come on, get on with
I've
it.
Only got an hour or so before I've got to go play footy.
Well done.
Bless you, mate.
Right.
See you later, Al.
See ya.
When the boys meet girls.
The future of the pop group Take That is unclear after newspaper reports that they're planning to split up. The band themselves, who've had seven number one singles, will reveal all in a press conference tomorrow.
Can we just say thanks for everybody's support in the last 5 years? You've been absolutely fantastic to us. But unfortunately, the rumours are true, and from today, is no more.
Thousands of teenage girls were left inconsolable. Followers of Take That were stunned by
the sudden decision. One of the most successful pop acts since the Beatles, with 25 million.
The company has set up a special phone line to counsel distraught fans.
I just couldn't believe it. I didn't think they'd ever do it.
We've had I've betted Howard £100 that Robbie shows up.
Well, you're going to be broke, lad.
I think he's not going, and Jay thinks he is.
Guys, we asked Robbie to come tonight. He's declined.
Oh, come on, where is he?
I'm gutted that Robbie's not coming.
No, me too.
Yeah, I'm gutted.
Gutted because it would have finished the story off nicely. We started out as a five, and to finish this as a five, it would have been a nice ending. Well, like when I came back 5 years ago with the other three lads, I had feelings that I didn't know what they were, and it was just like dark, foreboding stuff. What, go back there, do that? That was 10 years. That's gone. It was just total and utter nonsense for me to even contemplate it.
I'd just like to say thank you very much to everyone for giving us the last 10 years off. But unfortunately, the rumours are true. Take That are going back on tour.
Britain's biggest boy band.
Take That, the boy band of the 90s.
Dreamt of this day.
It's our first record after 11 years. Can't believe we're doing it.
A decade on, but they're at the top of the charts. David Sillerton.
Feels great, mate. Really good.
It's a case of Take That, Take Two last night when they wowed thousands of fans.
For Robbie Williams at the time when his former bandmates are reliving Take That's glory.
Tonight's live vote for British single is Take That!
Most of that 10 years off, I've lost a ton of confidence. I could never see us being in a position again where we'd be on a stage and there'd be a big audience, and I never thought it would happen.
You just look out and you see all them people and you think, what have we done to deserve this? I just feel so lucky.
When we first got back together, Rob coming working with us, if I'm honest, why would he, you know? But we managed to get ourselves into a place where the bridge was easier to walk over.
Negotiate these dogs.
He's ready to go. They're all ready to go. My God, they look good.
Now look
they
out.
Look good. I can tell. You're putting the fear of God in us.
Oh, you're missing out.
Yeah, what's happening?
You better stay out. I can see now.
You see? Look at that.
I'll show you what, I'm not very good at football. I'll show me how to.
Now listen, Rob, I've got to warn you. Rob, I'm shit out, but I'm even shitter in net. Just to warn you.
Right.
Don't be annoyed with us, will you?
I will not be annoyed with you, I promise.
Clever.
You know what do though, when they say one-on-one, is you come out of your goals to narrow the angles. You don't stay on your goal line. All right, okay, sorry.
I've had years of being in goal at school. Okay. I was that bad. I know that much. But don't you do it like that?
Yeah.
Oh, no, I am going to be sore tomorrow.
It's just,
it's that realization that you're going to hurt tomorrow before you even start.
Howard, please,
first time we've ever played as five. Lads, we're doing fucking brilliant.
Here we go. Makes it fun, right? That's it.
Right, we did all right, didn't we? We didn't make
right.
Total asses of ourselves, did we?
No.
Give them a game.
We should start our own five-a-side team. We've got a great goal, like.
I could be the manager.
Oh, you did
all right. Oh, hey. Oh, that's
staying up in Beverly Hills. This is like the fifth time I've been here this week. I'm just drawn to this area. I really love it. I think the mornings are so beautiful down here. Everyone always says, oh yeah, we're gonna come tomorrow. They never do. I wanna get them all down here. I'll tell you why. Because it's very rare we can all go out to like a little cafe, sit and have our scrambled eggs. No one bother us. So that's what I love coming down here. Sit there in the mornings, just no one's got a clue. You can't really do that back in England. So it's great.
To go back a little bit. Back it up a little bit. There's one bit we felt like we missed.
Very good.
But I sang it on top of you as well, so I'm sure we got it.
I get the feeling that we are being light. There's a surge in my psychosis every turn of the screw.
You know,
it can't be us sounding like Robbie's last record, and it can't be us sounding like our last record. We've got to adopt some of what Rob does, we've got to adopt some of what we do and move this forward.
I want it to be better. I want the words to have more meaning. I want them to emote more. I want them to, you know, write that universal song that sinks into every home in the valley, that sinks into every home in the valley in Wales, or Ashton Underline or Tunstall or Hanley. You know, I want it to touch people.
I've got to go.
All right, thanks for that.
Leave me with them lyrical challenges.
God bless you, mate. It's been lovely to see you. See you when we get back to the UK.
Wow.
Have a safe journey on, mate.
Yeah, cheers, mate. See you later.
Have you got that? Okay.
Hello, Boward. See you soon.
Have you got that?
Oh, doggy, don't go.
See you, mate.
See you, mate.
A safe flight, though.
Good one. We'll get the next few days.
Yeah, yeah.
I never really wanted to be in a band. I never felt like I got to the end of Take That and thought, there's my long-lost friends I'm saying farewell to, because we'd all been stitched together by a manager. We'd travelled the world for, like, 5 years all together, but we're just 20-year-old kids having a laugh, going round the world, having hits everywhere. Deep emotional stuff, none. Zero. I never had a deep emotional conversation with anyone.
It's just a skin loose.
So when Rob's coming in saying I had four bottles of vodka last night and I feel rotten today, we're just like, listen, rehearsals are beginning in 10 minutes. Just get in your place.
I suppose there was a lot of psychological warfare back in the day because we were all scrambling as 20-year-olds to be heard. And as well, I don't think we had, as 20-year-olds, we didn't have the education of how to get along because we were 20.
I always had this understanding when I look back on it that Robbie was young when he left the group. He was a baby when he came into it and he didn't know any better. You know, he's growing up, he was learning about music and he just had enough. But unfortunately, it was all left in the wrong way, really.
I just snapped whatever bit of control anybody once had. That just went, and I just... Not that I didn't give a shit anymore, I couldn't give a shit. And then Jay sat down at dinner and all the lads were like, you know when you're saying that you're gonna leave after this tour? Well, we think you should go now. And that was all I needed to go, yeah, I'm out.
I have thought, why didn't I say, no, this ain't gonna happen? It's not right that this doesn't happen. And that's just because I was, you know, too afraid of, I don't know what the fear was of, really, but just didn't have a voice. You didn't have a voice. Wasn't in a position to... I was probably so insecure about my own standing within the band that, you know, still in the back of your mind, you heard that voice that said you could be replaced tomorrow. You know? So, just keep your head down. Keep working.
If you could really and truly measure the reasons of why Robbie Williams at 21 left Take That, you could probably say half and half. Half because he wanted to go and he needed to go and fulfil his destiny. And half because people got annoyed with him and encouraged him to go and effectively threw him out. My main feeling was one of relief because it wasn't me. And I beat myself up for a good couple of years for being the spokesperson when Robbie was leaving. In my effort to ingratiate myself with the management, I joined with the lads in suggesting to Rob that he should go now.
I didn't make it easy for them.
you know, it was difficult enough for them without, you know, one-fifth of the team self-destructing. We didn't need such a tight rein. We were all desperate. We're all working class lads, all teenagers, given the golden ticket. And you believe that to be the golden ticket. This is your one chance to not fuck your life up and to make something of yourself. You know, you sort of follow blindly. You don't realise that you're a backing dancer until a few years in. You go, hang on. I didn't sign up for that. I would have done. You know, I would have signed up to be Gary Barlow's backing dancer. But that was not my understanding of the gig.
He wanted a voice. We all should have had a voice. I think they're his main memories of those days, was that he was just a workman. Not even the foreman. I was the foreman, you know. I think he was, you know, a frustrated writer. I think he should have been encouraged to have been a writer early on and didn't get that. Only ever got rejection off me. So I wanted to do all the writing, you know. I wanted to do all the singing as well. I never encouraged Rob to sing. That was his main point. And I have to go, yeah, that's true.
After all was said and done, more was said and done, an illusion of substance was all that we'd become. Is that too wordy, or is that nice, or is that wrong?
I love your friends, though. My friend. Because then you're saying, that is the difference, I fell in love with the enemy.
Yeah. Yeah, and the enemy and the difference, if I'm singing it from my point of view, is Oasis and the enemy. Celebrity.
I didn't know it was about you, this, when I heard the tape.
It's about anything that you see it as.
I think it's
what's
about
it
us.
About to you?
It's always been about us.
It feels about it. That's what I'm saying. It doesn't feel about you. It feels about us, this song, as I've heard it so far.
Well, you know, we became this parade on the streets
yeah.
that we once
yeah,
cleaned.
Please.
Expendable soldiers smiling at anything, raised on a feeling in our lives. I mean, we were once the answer, then you discover you were actually just one thing after another.
Yeah, one boy band after another.
Yeah, so this is all that matters now, the getting back together. Mm-hmm. And that was all that mattered anyhow. You can look back, but don't stare, because it's ugly. Maybe I could love you out of there. Perhaps, you know, we can get together and heal this shit. What I think is, what I forgot to say was I love you.
Yeah.
You know, that's
yeah.
what I think.
Yeah.
If you know what it means
so
to
then
me.
Then go on to your second verse.
And outside forces didn't make it easy.
Yeah, I think that's two.
It's ace.
I like the fact that it's like you've had your resolution. You're getting to the point of resolution instantly.
After all was said and done, more was said than done. For me, was when we had band meetings. We'd go, we'll do this and we'll do that and we'll do this, and nothing
yeah.
would ever happen.
Yeah. Next line.
There isn't one. The only reason I'm reticent to change it is because we just need one more line and this is a fucking shit hot lyric. And it's already there. You know? And outside forces didn't make it easy, so I thought I'd go before you leave me. That's heartbreaking.
But just listen to me out 1 second. So, and after all was said, more was said than done. Da 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 da. Outside forces. So just slightly, so you could just slightly turn it around a little bit.
So it's hard for me looking on this, but you're one line away.
We are one line away.
What you need it to be, this song.
Well, I'm not talking about rewriting the whole song.
But it depends whether you want it to be different to get some lines in that you've not. I don't know why.
Being attached to my lines.
No,
at
just
all, in any way, shape,
just trying
form.
To.
Which line, Rob, is it?
Yeah.
It's just that one and we've got it and it's wonderful.
You don't mind me saying something, Robert?
Mm-hmm.
The first verse, when I heard it, I thought it was about us and it was so beautiful.
It is about us.
But the second verse, when you start saying, I thought I'd go before you leave me, it's about you, which you know, for the listener, they'll know straight away it's about you.
I just think as a bit of poetry for the type of song that we're singing, the first verse could be about us. That line in itself could just be about me. It doesn't all, you know, it doesn't all have to be about the same thing. And I think it's beautiful.
It is, but it's your song.
I know you're putting it to one bit there, Jay, to that day Rob left, but we could have all been thinking that. I don't think the way forward's going, let's get something better. I think you've got to come to the table with something better. If you want to change something, you've got to go try this instead.
No, I don't think it's a better line. It's not about better or worse line. I'm just pointing something out here. The first half of the song and the chorus is about us. Mm. And it's beautiful. It's about us. But that becomes about you. And which I'm not saying
you shouldn't have it
for that reason, but I'm just pointing it out.
But it doesn't though. It's only that line.
You don't have to convince me, but I think it's a brilliant line. I'm not disputing that. It's a brilliant lyric. It just comes about something else, which might be appropriate.
I understand what you're saying, Jay, and you know, but I think that the reason why I'm so passionate about it is because those first two verses took me 2 or 3 days of constant thinking. I was going na na da 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 da, and then if I sit down and I go, you know, and you say it's about that,
yeah,
and you're more than you have every right to say it,
yeah.
But I do feel.
Feel connected to those lyrics.
I feel
connected. So much time.
Yeah, you know. I'm sorry if I'm defensive.
But there's a reason for all that.
Or yeah, I apologise for, you know, coming in so no. But you know, I feel strongly about it.
Yeah.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
I didn't know I was precious.
No.
It's all good. I think we all will know when it's right.
I'm sorry, lads. I'm being a little bit overprotective of what I've done.
No, well, you are.
I don't want you to think you can't come
the
and
passion,
go.
The passion is good. That's
yeah.
what we need.
I don't want you
Without
to think
that
you can't come and go, I've changed this.
Yeah.
And I'm sorry that, you know. That
it's alright. I understand, Rob. Now you put it like that, I totally understand. Fair enough.
You know, let's talk out until it's gone. You know what I mean? It's gone anyway, hasn't it?
Oh, it's gone, yeah.
I mean, there was a little moment where you said, are you trying to get your lines in?
No,
so, I find that really...
No, hang
right.
on. Let me explain myself, because I knew you'd take
totally,
it like that, Mark.
It's totally not how I am.
No, my point is this, though, is that we have taste, all of us, and it's different. And
yeah,
it depends whether is putting your taste of line in there
right.
better than...
No.
That's
no,
what I mean.
No, I completely agree with
that. And that's what... See, I knew you'd take it the wrong way when I said that, though. That's what I meant.
Yeah.
But Mark, that's why I love you, because you won't let it go. But I love that as well, because it makes for excellence, that does. That's why our stuff's always been as good as it is, because all your detail. It's the same with the tour. The driver's up the fucking wall, you do. But it's worth it, because it's brilliant when it's done. See? Do care.
Give us a hug.
The answer, and then you decide.
that was fucking ace. From top to finish.
It's just a fraction of time. Until we move in reverse. Can feel the pressure in all our minds.
It's definitely time to start living with the album as a whole. I think we're, you know, we're after living as songs as individuals now.
Yeah.
And it's just now it takes life as an album.
Yeah.
And as a whole thing. I mean, what in 10 years' time would you look back and put on it? And more importantly, in 10 years' time, what are you going to go, why the fuck did we put that on there?
I suppose we have to make that decision now. Is this album going to be a statement? Because I think that that's where what we should do. I don't think we should water it down. 20 years of being around, 20 years of what we're doing, we've got to make this record that you put on and you just go, oh my. And give people either, let's not go down the middle, let's either be awesome or fucking shit. Let's be really bold in our decision making and be sure of what we want for us. You know? Right, I'm off now.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
My greatest fear is maybe you will notice I'm not what you wanted after all those years. But I got a very big hope for us. It's been a difficult year. And I still wanna make love with you. So where shall we go? What do you want from me? What do you want from me? I still think I'm in love with you. I still wanna belong to you. So what do you want from me? What do you want from me now?
For years, he has been a squeaky clean singer in one of the world's biggest boy bands. Mark Owen has revealed a much murkier side after
the
admitting
to cheating. The man who wrote the story says Mark has issues that do point to a reason.
Mark Owen is in rehab. He's called himself a prat.
They are doing so well, aren't they, as a band at the moment, and yet we're now learning that there's a whole new side to stuff that we didn't know anything about, but he's been struggling by the sound.
Hard work to make a record, and I'm not just talking now, it's the whole 20 years of emotions and things that are all attached to this thing that you're trying to deal with. You go through a lot of a big journey in your own mind and your life, and you try and piece it together. Where did you come from to end up at this point? I didn't really know I was that broke, but I was pretty fucking broke when I look at it now. Drink and me equals not good, really. When I was in rehab, you know, for those 4 weeks, I was able to look back over my life a lot and think about the band the first time around and think about the band this time around and look at my behaviour and look at, like, who I was or who I wasn't. Kind of become this person that I didn't really recognise. How did that happen? Just how the fuck did that happen? You silly bastard. There was a time when I was like, I can't ever go in the studio again. Can't do this. It's just not who I am, what have I been doing? I spoke to Emma, you know, and she said that's not the way to deal with this, you know, that's in a way running away. And then I thought, well, you know, that's quite selfish because we've come this far now, done this work, and don't let everybody down. You've let everybody down enough. Don't let them all down again. The definition of a man. 'Cause when all our work is done, we're just soldiers heading home.
One of the issues we had in the first time around was if somebody was suffering a bit and going through some stuff, there was no time for that person. You had to just keep grinding on for the sake of everybody else and for the sake of the business and success. But this time we have to put each other first, and so we all tried our best to put Mark's feelings first, you know. And there was no pressure to come back, and just when he was ready, really.
Free your soul to me. Free your soul to me.
I've always been interested in music. Before I was even in tech, that I was DJing, I was mixing tapes, being very musical, but by ear. So for me to come in with a big musician like Gary and then go to a main recording studio, write backing tracks, it's important to me.
That classic sort of backing vocal sound that Take That have is Howard Donald's. He's amazing at it. He's just, you know, he's the shit. He's brilliant at it.
Scooby dooby dooby doo. No sign of it.
Here we go, kids. Oh, yes. Get ready. This bag of goodies.
Look at this bag of goodies. This is actually the full set of production pedals. But these are the rare finds, these ones, because these are the prototypes. Actually, that never went to a production pedal, that one. That just stayed as an idea. There's the famous hand-painted version of those. I've told Ryan not to put stickers on the bottom of these because they're hand-painted. The stickers will peel off some of the paint. I'm going to have him when he gets back up here. He's got no respect for these pedals. Dear Rhino hasn't, but... That's a right little beauty, that one is. That's a fabulous pedal. As you can see, that's the prototype to that one there. So, you ever feel like a nice long dinner with me talking about this? Write your name on the back of a stamped addressed envelope, send it in. But it's a bit of a hobby, all this. Bit of fun. Keeps me out of the news of the world. Hey, see that? There's no harm in this.
down, down. Let your crazy out. Boys go crazy over you. Grip like a New York window cleaner, just staring at you. You don't leave me here, stay on me.
You know, I mean, my problem's always been with Gary. Well, my problem always was with Gary.
Robbie Williams and Gary Barlow have spent months bickering about who was responsible for the band's demise.
It is really coming all from Robbie.
You've begun to get annoyed by people's ego.
Who is, out of the pair of them, considered to be the most talented?
It was hard watching Rob getting further and further into the distance, and I just seemed like I'd gone 10 steps back. When you're as big as he is, at that point, when you say things once, they're everywhere. It was just like a constant, daily mock. It went on and on and on, and it just never seemed to stop. And then as I felt like it was stopping, then Rob would say something else, and it'd start all again.
But I was always the talented member of the band.
Followed me everywhere I went, on holiday, to nursery, to school, when I'm buying a new car, when I'm going shopping. They just follow you everywhere, those jokes, that people want to join in. Hey, up, Gary, how's Robbie? You know, it just follows you everywhere. And you just feel like a total loser, like a total loser. In fact, I remember talking to the bank to ask, could I change on my credit card the name, so I didn't have to say my name, because as soon as I said it, people would go and they'd make some wisecrack, even over the phone. I just couldn't get away from it.
I wanted to crush him. I wanted to crush the memory of the band, you know. And I didn't let go, you know. Even when he was down, I didn't let go. And for that, you know, I sincerely apologize. But I needed Gary to listen to my truth, to listen to what my experience was, and I needed him to validate it for me. And he validated it for me. And it was a real fucking magical moment, you know, because then you realize when two grown-ups meet and one goes, here's my truth, and they go, yeah, I'm sorry. And the other one goes, here's my truth, yeah, I'm sorry. There's room for movement then, you know, as and then you realize that, you know, you hurt so much because you love them so much.
The Rob I'm with now is not the guy. I certainly wasn't the guy I was with in the 90s. I needed those years. It needed to happen to me, that, to get to here. I had to have those years. I almost want to say thanks. All that shit, it was great because it made me reach my bottom. And now look at me.
Bye.
he's gone way beyond being a father figure and taking care of us and driving this machine and being the captain of the ship. And I'm incredibly happy to be under his tutorage, because he's the man.
One of the things that was a big revelation to me when joining the band again this time round was how much I loved everyone's company and hearing about, what are you feeling? How are you feeling about that? I wasn't interested the first time round. It was just, this is a waste of time. What, can we do something else? I've loved that this time. I've loved the emotional connection to everyone. I've loved being a part of people's lives and hearing when someone's not happy about something. And I've come in today and I've had a rotten weekend, and I love all that.
First single, Hands Up for Flood.
Yeah! I'm not sure. I need to think about it a little
bit. Let's play second singles.
No, I need to think about it a little bit.
Have you decided? Is it going to be the Flood?
I think it should be the Flood.
Yeah, you and me, we can ride all the sun. second single.
Wait.
Well, do we need to decide that now?
No, but let's play it.
We're having fun, Jay.
Yeah, you and me, we can ride all the sun.
No, I'm not sure because...
Wait. We are playing a game.
We've called the album Progress, and perhaps we've only just begun to progress, like a year, almost a year of living and breathing together, and we're just starting. We're starting our journey together, and now it's what goes on beyond here.
Let's play third single.
Third single.
Kids is a tune.
That's the problem we're going to have, isn't
it? Well, I think Happy Now is a bigger tune than Kids.
I think Kids is a bigger tune than Happy Now.
Is that because you're doing the lead vocal?
Yeah. Is that because you're doing the lead on Happy Now?
Absolutely.
Now Rob's come back into the band, maybe this is the place, maybe this is the time for us all to make peace with the whole thing and to reflect a little bit on the journey. And our different journeys as well that we've all been on, you know, to learn from each other and see where each other went during those 10, 15 years, you know. Hello, putty cat. Here they come. Here's trouble. You all right? You coming up? Yay!
What is that for? What is that?
That?
What is it called?
No, that's a microphone.
You really think you'll never have a drink again?
I can't.
You can't?
No.
I haven't had a drink for 10 years, Gaz, but I wouldn't
not
be able to tell
you. Not
talking
about you.
Yeah, talk about me. I was facing this way then. Oh, right. I've got a drinking problem too. Yeah. It's not just him.
Just everybody's forgot about mine.
Yeah. I fucking drink again.
Just to spite you all.
Yeah.
It will be. It's going to be times, I'm sure, that I'm going to hit where it's like, whoa, things. It's kind of nice to feel that you've got people around you to give you support. I mean,
yeah. It'll be a right bag of laughs being on top of these two, isn't it?
Oh, don't worry, Alice.
Should we go to the bat?
Oh,
I'll have relapsed by then on some sort
brilliant.
Of.
Good.
Either prescription medication or Colombian stuff or whatever. Don't worry about it.
Good.
I won't let you down.
How are you feeling, him?
Right,
so.
Ask me about my problems now.
Well, it was I was just warming up on Mark. Right. So, Rob, let's really talk through things. How's Ida? All going good?
Fucking brilliant.
You say that every time I see you, but you don't seem to be doing anything about it.
We're getting married.
Aha! I'm really good at weddings.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Really good.
I
do
love
a great little
just
set while they're coming in for the dinners.
You are.
Get the organ. Don't go changing.
No, we're going to do it last minute. So it's going to be like, no one knows, no one's got a clue. Bang, we're doing it.
What's happening tomorrow then?
Oh. There's actually nothing happening tomorrow, isn't
What are you doing tomorrow, Rob?
Nothing.
Do you want to do out?
Yeah.
Sometimes I go back 20 years and go, Christ, you know, these five guys that were just came together in a gay club in Manchester for an audition. Wow, look at this. Look what we are now as a team. Look what we're doing. Look what's possible.
All of a sudden, I'm inspired. There's something to work for and there's some people to work with. There's nothing for me to do other than be and take that. I'm fucking bored, I'm scared, I'm lonely, and I've said everything that I want to say in a record. I'm enjoying this too much. Sharing everything. To want to go back. To being in the Robbie Williams band. I'm breaking me up. Yeah. I'm breaking me up because of musical similarities.
I'm not vain.
It's needed the process of writing an album for us to really get to know each other again. And we are really getting to know each other.
I never thought when I first went into the studio with Rob, I would enjoy myself as much as I have done.
He's just a great person. He's a great person to be around.
You know, there's no such thing as a perfect relationship, but what there is acceptance and forgiveness or an effort to get to those places with each other. There is a bit of a way to go. There's room for improvement, there always is, but how much we've come on from 20 years ago when it was just dog eat dog. It was every man for themselves. And now we're trying to help each other, and it's quite a transformation, really.
This is the press release for the end of the week, and I need a quote from you.
I get embarrassingly excited when the father was in the room. It feels like coming home.
It's been an amazing experience, an amazing journey. I feel like I want us to all put our arms around each other, give each other a little pat on the back and say, well done, guy. You know, we're here now, we're nearly 40, we're all around that 40 mark. Well done for getting this far. It's just that honesty, isn't it? It's getting this honesty with each other. A new honesty. Yeah, we don't have to pretend anymore.
Robbie Williams is back in
Take That are back. They're reforming this night.
After months of speculation, Take That has told Robbie Williams.
Saga that has consumed pop music for the last 15 years.
Of course, that Robbie is joining Take That again. The band is reforming.
Robbie Williams.
Robbie Williams. Back in the day.
Yeah, it was really me.
Take That.
Take That.
It's a nouvelle extraordinaire.
The grudge against Robbie Williams. Robbie Williams.
A solo career.
And Take That.
Take That.
I've formed Robbie Williams begleiter.
Because ultimately, there's a kind of invisible glue that pulls you all back together.
Comes off. You might notice your wage packet a little bit lighter this month, Rhino.
I don't think I did it.
Here we go.
is a fucking nuts.
Happy birthday, dear Robbie. Happy birthday to you.
Prime Minister of the country.
Okay, not Godiva, the one that you said.
Okay. Big chin, Chacho.
Yeah!